السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في الكتاب الكريم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، آمين. أما بعد، we begin in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We begin by praising Him and by glorifying Him as He ought to be praised and glorified. He says subhanahu wa ta'ala, يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. That everything that's in the skies, everything that's in the earth, everything that's in the universe, everything in the deepest parts of the sea, wherever you can see, whatever you can't see, it's all praising and glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continuously. And this whole universe is in complete state of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's in complete submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes in Surah Ar-Ra'd, He says, don't you see that the entire heavens and the earth is making sajda to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Talking about the planets and the stars. In Surah Ar-Rahman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says the trees and the plants are making sajda to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything is worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so we begin by joining this universal movement of praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And by doing so, we are part of the majority. Sometimes we look at the world and we say, us Muslims are a minority and we're being persecuted, this and that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, no, you guys are the majority. You are part of this grand movement that is there in submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here's the difference. You are choosing to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are choosing to be one of this movement. Everything else in the creation doesn't have of what happened in the past when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just created Adam alayhi salam. That there was this trust, this great amana, and he offered it to the skies. The skies have said, no Allah, we cannot handle this trust. Then he offered it to the mountains. The mountains, they said, no ya Allah. The earth said, no ya Allah, we can't handle this. The human being, you and me, we took this trust upon ourselves. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, indeed the human being, they're not very, very foresighted. Sometimes we don't see the difficulties that we get ourselves into. But the reality is, we have been placed with this trust and we have this amana in our hands. What is the amana? The story is, they said, you have the choice as to what happens to you. Everything in the heavens and the earth belongs to Allah. Their fate is decided ultimately by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the human being chose for themselves. They said, ya Allah, let me choose what happens to me. And so some of them come here and they choose to destroy themselves. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you know, وَمِن ذُرِّيَّتِهِمْ مَنْ أَبْ مَنْ وَسَّعِيَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, from the children, talking about the children of Ibrahim and Yaqub and Ishaq, it says, from their children, there are some who are good to themselves, and there are some who wrong themselves. And the choice was left up to you and me. And so, one of the key things that this choice gave us is the ability to be either grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created human beings, there's this huge scene that took place in the heavens. Allah created Adam alayhi salam and He commanded all the angels, O angels, bow down to my creation. Why? Because this creation I have honored, I have taught him the names, I have given him free will, I have given him the choice. All the angels bowed down. And there was one guy amongst them, he said, I'm not going to bow to this guy. Why should I bow to him? You created me from fire, you created him from dirt, I'm better than this dirt. Right? So he please didn't want to bow down. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, What stopped you from bowing down, O Iblis? What prevented you from bowing down? When I commanded you to bow down, he says, I'm better than him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, okay, ukhruj minha, fainaka rajim, so get down from here, you are cursed. This is not a place for you to become arrogant. Now there is an interesting thing that's taking place. Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala know that Iblis was going to disobey when he created Adam alayhi salam and asked the angels to bow down? Did he have this knowledge? Yes, he did. Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala know that Adam alayhi salam was going to disobey and come down into the earth, come from the Jannah to down to the earth? Did he know that? Yes, in fact, he even announced it. وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. I'm going to create in the earth a khalifa. So the knowledge was already there. It had already been predestined. Here's the key thing. It had already been predestined. The qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was set in place. But now that all the things have been said and done, Iblis turns around and says, Ya Allah, you knew. You knew I wasn't going to bow down to him. You set me up. That was a trap. He says, Ya Allah, because you misguided me, I'm going to declare war on all of them. I'm going to come to them from front of them, from behind them, from their right, from their left, and I'm going to make sure most of them are ungrateful to you. This is the promise of Iblis. Adam alayhi salam, he disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He eats from the tree Allah told him not to eat from. He comes down to the earth and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Oh Adam, why did you disobey? He says, Ya Allah. He could have said, Ya Allah, you set me up. You said I was going to be on the earth. But what does he say? ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا. Allah, we wronged ourselves. He takes personal responsibility. Now that's the first thing about choice. Every time we make a choice, who is responsible for that choice? You, me, we are responsible for every choice that we make. And Adam alayhi salam has that understanding. He says, رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا. Oh Allah, we have wronged ourselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Adam alayhi salam took personal responsibility, Allah turns to Adam alayhi salam with His mercy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevates Adam alayhi salam, makes him a prophet. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him guidance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you and your wife and your children stay on this earth for a short time. And I'm going to send you guidance from myself. Whoever obeys my guidance, follows my guidance, they will come right back to Jannah. Whoever turns away from my guidance, they will be the greatest losers. And so, alhamdulillah, you and me were here sitting in the masjid. That means part of us at least have been obeying this guidance. Now, part of the guidance of this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَكُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَتَاعًا إِلَى حِينٍ. You have on this earth a small amount of measured time. Small amount of measured time. And what is the test of this earth? Why are we on this earth? One of the scholars has said, the test of being on the earth is to see, are you number one, grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And are you number two, willing to let go of what you have for the sake of Allah? And so, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know, one time in a state of extreme hunger, it's a battle time, people are about to attack Medina and people are digging the trenches and everything. He's extremely hungry and a person comes up to him and says, Ya Rasulullah, I have some food at home for you. Just you, Ya Rasulullah, come. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turns around and invites everybody to this guy's house. He says, everyone, food party at this guy's house. So all of Sahaba are coming and he's panicking. We only have small amount of food. He runs home, tells his wife, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam invited everybody. How are we going to feed everyone? His wife says, if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam invited them, calm down, don't worry. Allah will take care of it. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes, he says, enter the house 10 at a time. He goes into the house, he says, what are you making, sister? She says, I'm making soup, Ya Rasulullah. He says, no problem. Put the bread, put the things, and let me do the rest. She says, okay. She puts the bread, she prepares the soup, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam goes in there, he makes a dua over the soup, and he starts serving the sahaba, 10 at a time. And there's over 500 something sahaba, and they all eat to their fill. They all eat to their fill. And then as he's sitting down, he's remembering just the hunger that he had. He had two stones tied to his stomach. As soon as the hunger is gone, he's back to his senses. He looks at the sahaba, he says, Allah's going to ask us about this. This is ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And don't you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you know, on that day, he's going to ask you about the na'im, all the blessings that Allah gave to you. And so the sahaba, they said, Ya Rasulullah, what is the smallest type of ni'mah we should be worried about? What's the smallest thing Allah's going to ask us about? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took a deep breath. The breath. You're breathing right now. You don't even think about it. But we're breathing. A lot of people, they don't, but we have to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for every single ni'mah that He gives us. Every single ni'mah. Because if we're not grateful, we'll be asked about it. I gave you this, what did you do? Ya Allah, I spent it, I didn't care. No, you're supposed to be grateful. That was the whole point of this test. Are you grateful? And one of the scholars said, imagine if you woke up tomorrow and you only had whatever you thanked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for today. So if you said, Ya Allah, thank you for the eyes, thank you for the car, thank you for the house, you woke up tomorrow, all you had was eyes, car, and a house. That's it. Right? What would you have left? If you woke up tomorrow and the only things you had was things you thanked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for today. So that's the first test. The second test is, are you willing to let go of things, the dunya things, to build your akhirah? Why? Because in reality, the dunya is passing. Everybody knows that. You're going to die, I'm going to die, we're all going to die. And the signs of this is we're getting old, our health is deteriorating, our hair is falling out. SubhanAllah, a few months ago, a huge patch of my hair fell out. I said, that's a sign. It's coming. Right? So, the reality is here. We're all going to die. And you can earn dunya, build up a whole mountain of wealth for yourself. In the end, what's going to happen? There's a small place in the earth for us, made of dirt, not gold, not silver, not walls, just dirt. And you go in there, whether you're rich, whether you're poor, that's where you're going to go. That's all you take from the dunya. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, oh human beings, invest for your future. Send forward for yourself so that you could be on that day of judgment among the honored ones. And so this dunya, he says subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَا حَيَاتِ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. What is the life of dunya except enjoyment of delusions? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sometimes takes away from us by force. Because sometimes we're not willing to let go. So Allah says, okay, make his business crash. Business crashes. We're crying, it's mine. Why did this happen? Allah says, no, it wasn't yours. It was a gift, I gave it to you. You're not willing to let it go. So you know what? I called you back to myself so you can make tawbah. So you can turn around. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing us to see how much are you and me willing to let go for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one time Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, somebody gave him a sheep. He brought it home to Aisha radiallahu anha after sacrificing it and then preparing the meat. He gave it to her and said, go and distribute this meat to the poor. She took this meat, she went out, she distributed it and everything. She came back home, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, right time he came, he said, oh Aisha, what did you do with the sheep? She said, Ya Rasulullah, I gave all of it, I gave all of it except for the shoulder. I saved the shoulder for you and me. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, oh Aisha, in fact you have saved all of it except for the shoulder. You have saved all of it except for the shoulder. So the reality is whatever you give up from the dunya, you actually are saving it for yourself in the akhirah. It's like a, you know, transfer account, you transfer it from your dunya to your akhirah. And so we conclude with this. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase us in our generosity. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase us in our iman. Ask Allah for forgiveness. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى أما بعد. الحمد لله. So we're sitting in this house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This building, as you can see, mashallah, we have carpets from the same carpets as Masjid al-Aqsa. And this place has brought so much benefits to the community. We've had so many different programs. Programs for youth, programs for adults, religious programs, IT programs, you name it. We've had, you know, a recent program, one of the recent programs, youth leadership program, where we're teaching kids to learn the deen and to go out there and be able to teach the deen. We have programs, IT programs that's coming up, you know, programs you would pay $2,500 to learn, PMP and all of these certifications, only $100 for the people in this community. And this place was established by the members of this community with no interest. You know, when they decided to buy this place, they said, how should we do this? Some of the ideas on the table was, well, it's a lot of money, let's borrow money from the bank and pay this place. And alhamdulillah, Allah gave us people sensible enough to put their foot down and they said, no way, we're not going to build a house to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we start building it by disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're not going to let that happen. And so we went out, we borrowed some money from the community members, Qadi Hasana. We had $150,000 in debt. And we paid off, alhamdulillah, most of it. We have $62,000 left. And you and me were sitting here in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the blessed time of Ramadan where the deeds are multiplied and everything. And I'm asking you, give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and save your wealth for yourself. Spend in the path of Allah and send it forward for yourself. So on the day of judgment, when you come out, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has all these rewards racked up for you. And He says, remember you gave to the masjid, all you could give was $10, remember that day? Well, I multiplied it for you. That's all you could give, $10, I know. I multiplied it for you and I made it 700 times more in deeds and hasanat. And so enter Jannah, because of the investment you have made for yourself. And so this is an opportunity, and you know, take this opportunity very seriously. I'm not asking you for your money. I'm not. I don't need your money. But you need to spend this money for yourself. You need to do this for yourself. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you who believe, anfiqhu mimma razaqna, give from what we give to you. Before the day comes, when there is no more trade, there is no more shafa, there is nothing on that day. On the day of judgment, if you hold on to it today, you can't come and say, Ya Allah, I see hellfire now, let me spend now. Allah says, no. Time is up. You know, if you want to spend for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, now is the time. Who knows whether we're going to be alive tomorrow or not. And so we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower this gathering with His blessings. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase our iman, increase our taqwa. We ask Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, forgive all of our sins, Ya Allah. The major ones and the minor ones, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, we ask You to increase our good deeds, Ya Allah. And Ya Allah, we ask You to make us among the honored ones in this Ramadan, Ya Allah. Free us from hellfire, Ya Allah. Guide us and our children, Ya Allah, to the straight path, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, we ask You, Ya Allah, those that are living amongst us, Ya Allah, we ask You to protect us, Ya Allah. Like You would protect one of Your righteous servants, Ya Allah. And those that have passed away from among us, Ya Allah. Expand their graves for them, Ya Allah. And fill it with nur for them, Ya Allah. And forgive all of their sins, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, Rahman, Ya Rahim, we ask You. Anyone going through difficulties, Ya Allah, we ask You to grant us ease, Ya Allah. In their health, Ya Allah, we ask You to grant us shifa, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, anyone going through difficulties in their families, Ya Allah. Unite our hearts, Ya Allah. And make our homes places of peace and tranquility, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, Rahman, Ya Rahim. Anyone going through difficulties in their struggling to submit to You, Ya Allah. Make this Ramadan the moment we make tawbah to You, Ya Allah. And we come back to You full force, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, Rahman, Ya Rahim. we ask you to not let us die except in a state of iman, ya Allah. And make our last words, la ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah, wa akhra da'wana, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad wa alayhi wa sahbihi ajma'in.